An ancient war between Israel and the Philistines. Amidst the fierce battle, a giant warrior named Goliath stepped forward.
Is there anyone brave enough to fight me? Send one man to face me. If he defeats me, we will become your servants.
According to the Bible, Goliath stood an astounding 2.9 meters tall, fully armored, and was the Philistines' mightiest warrior. The Israelite army was paralyzed with fear. No one had the courage to challenge this giant. But then, a young boy stepped forward.
I'll do it,
he said. This boy was David, a humble shepherd. David was neither a trained warrior, nor did he have any armor.
I've protected my sheep from lions and bears. God will protect me today as well.
Armed with nothing but 5 smooth stones, without armor or sword, David confronted Goliath. He launched a stone directly at Goliath's forehead, and the giant fell to the ground instantly. The story of David and Goliath is often cited to highlight the importance of courage and conviction. But this interpretation isn't quite accurate. The Bible mentions David used a sling, a primitive projectile weapon. A stone thrown from a sling can reach speeds over 150 kilometers per hour, delivering kinetic energy similar to a handgun bullet. A hard stone striking the forehead at this speed would be immediately lethal. But how could a simple sling be so powerful? A sling consists of a pouch made from leather or fabric connected by 2 cords. The user spins it around rapidly and then releases 1 cord, launching the stone forward at high speed. If you spin a 90-centimeter sling, moving your hand in a small circle with a radius of 10 centimeters. The stone at the sling's end moves in a circle with a radius of 100 centimeters. This means the stone travels at roughly 10 times the speed of your hand. So now, who was truly braver?